We're going to introduce you to a school that started a Jostens Renaissance effort, and what happened when they did. This is a nice school, but one facing the challenges that so many schools in America face today. Tight budgets, test scores, state regulations, positive behavior issues. So much about the numbers, not so much about the people. How do you possibly solve all these concerns and make your school a place people want to go to, not just a place people have to go to? Students and adults.
My name is Allie Stinson. I've been teaching here for 15 years. I'm the Renaissance co-advisor. I also teach math, and I'm also the yearbook advisor.
My name is Carrie Clifford, and I'm from Central Pennsylvania originally. I went to Altoonary High School. It's like a bigger high school, and decided I wanted to be a chemistry teacher.
Super small, very tight-knit community. Rural, but close enough to Altoona and State College to have access to some of those bigger things. But I think probably my biggest draw when I first came here was how close the community was. Like, it had like that small town feel, so everybody gets behind a lot of the sports teams and the school community, and the school becomes a very big center focus of what goes on in this community. There's not a lot of outside things, so the school is really like the central focus. And you know, our girls just went to the state final game for the second year in a row, and so the whole entire community was there. Like, we didn't have school. Like, that was just how important that was for everybody to be there and be supportive of those girls, as well as like our bocce team that had just gone down there as well. So there's just such a focus around the school, and I just like the small town feel and how supportive they were.
Before Renaissance, we have lots of good things going for our school district, just like most people's. We have lots of great sports going on. We have lots of kids doing really good things with academics. We have lots of kids going to really cool schools. We have a lot of good things going on, but like any school, you have things that you want to improve on. So some of the things that we saw as maybe areas that we could improve are like ways to recognize students for things that they're doing other than athletics. So students that went to really awesome universities or who got jobs after school instead of going to universities, like, they didn't really get a lot of recognition or any sort of like fun activities planned for them or anything that they could show off, like, hey, I'm going to here, or I'm doing this job after school. A lot of the representation in schools, which is normal, is for achievements for athletics. So like, there are lots of trophies everywhere and things like that for sports like baseball and basketball, and that's great. But not so much in other aspects of student life. So that's kind of something that we saw as a need to improve. And also school spirit. So a feeling of like togetherness is always something that you want to improve on as a teacher. And so we thought maybe we could improve that together and have students feel more as a body of one. So feel like that they're valued, that they're seen, heard, and loved, that we care about them and they're being heard, and that their opinions are valued, essentially.
You know, when you walk into our school, one of the first questions that they ask us there was, you know, what do you see? What do you feel? How does it feel when you walk into your school? And I think that when you walk in, that prior to last year, prior to even this summer, that it was kind of a blank slate, and we're trying to fill up those slates with all kinds of positive messages and inclusive messages, and making kids feel like they're seen, heard, and loved, and that they're welcome. And I don't think that necessarily it was bad, like, I didn't think it was bad, but I knew after listening to them that it could be so, so much better.
At that point, mostly the seniors, and some of the juniors too, came and were just talking about, well, why don't we do this at our school? Like, why don't we change this about what we do? Or, you know, if he can be that excited about his school and his students and they can care about each other in that way, then why can't we do it here? So there was more of a drive of like, okay, we've seen that it's different, we should do this differently together. And so we had more of a motivation from students to jump in with Allie and I and make a change at our school.
I think that we just were all on board with it. Like, and I think that the excitement that I brought back and the connections that I was able to make after the conference just kind of kept that fire going. And like I said, I've made so many connections with so many amazing educators since that event. through Twitter and just email and, you know, bouncing ideas off of them and having them respond to us. We were actually connected through Jostens with Dr. Steve Wolf. So having him as our coach has been amazing because he has, you know, been at similar size schools and done similar things that we would like to do. So many of the ideas that we have done and we have and want to do, we are, you know, communicating with him and being able to say, what do you think about this? Do you think that we could change this? How did you do this? And just connecting with all of those other amazing people that he has been able to connect us with as well. Like, our network of educators just keeps growing.
It was actually overwhelmingly positive. We had lots and lots of teachers come and ask us, I see that you guys are doing this. Is there any way that I could do something too? Or I hear you want to hold a homecoming dance. Is there any way that I could chaperone? Like, we had people asking us if they could be involved. We had parents come up to us during parent-teacher conferences before the school year started, because you have an open house usually, which is what we did. Parents were approaching us and saying, I love what you've done to even just like the hallways. I love what you guys have done to include my student. Before the school year had even started, were very, very positive. Even the superintendent was super excited about seeing the bathrooms and how well they were decorated and how we painted everything. It was overwhelmingly positive. I can't say that we even encountered one single like negative. So we were very well supported in the district, and the community was very receptive. And so were the students. They loved it.
We just started doing little things. We put notes on all of the lockers. We started doing a birthday wall. We did decorations in the hallways. Just really started to, you know, just take those little baby steps to see how things were accepted and whether or not it was something that we wanted to continue with. And it was like, kids at first were kind of confused as to why, but ultimately at the end of the day, it was, this is awesome. Like, I like having this on my locker. I like coming in and seeing these positive messages, and I like walking up the stairs and seeing things, you know, go up on the walls or go up in the hallways, and it just gives a more positive atmosphere to the whole place.
Our club motto is making sure kids feel seen, heard, and loved. And not just even kids, staff, faculty, everybody who's involved with the district. We want them to feel involved. So that's like the overarching mission. So anything that meets that goal, we say is fair game, right? Specifically, we have things to target student recognition. We have hung on each kid's locker who is going to a school or a workplace, like specifically where they're going to school. So like, if you're going to Pitt, we put a Pitt emblem on your thing. If you're not decided, we have something for you too, like to make sure every kid's included and recognized for what they do. We wanted kids to feel like they had a say in the way the school looks. So we let them paint our bathrooms. We let them help us decide what to put on lockers. We let them decorate the sidewalks at the beginning of the year. We want to give them a voice. So there are more specific things, like any teacher would like to improve attendance because that improves also performance. So we want kids to feel like they want to be here, and anything that helps us with that, we want to do. So we have lots of goals, but if it fits in that overarching theme of, does it make people feel seen, heard, and loved, then we tackle it.
I don't really know that there was pushback, but I'm sure that there was people that were thinking, you know, along those lines of, you know, what are they trying to do? I'm not really sure that they know what they're trying to do, but I think that, again, for me, they weren't at that event and they didn't see the passion and the purpose that I left there with, and the way that those two men were able to speak and, like I said, share their story. And so that, it didn't really matter. Like, and I think with anything, it takes a little while to get everyone on board. But I think if you just stay consistent and persistent with what you're doing, that, you know, they're eventually going to see that this isn't something that's going to go away, and this really is the best thing for the kids, and the kids are getting excited, and the kids are more willing to be involved in things that maybe they weren't involved in. And now you have kids that maybe felt a little bit excluded are now being included. And so that's really the goal, is that we just make it a place that people want to be.
It's very, very important to have administrative support. For example, a lot of the things that we want to plan, we don't necessarily know the ins and outs of. If you want to get something done at your school for your students, or your students want to get something done, then usually, I mean, you have to ask for permission to see what's feasible and what's not. In that sense, like, just for logistics it's important, but also because you're trying to change more than like the look of the school. You're trying to change more than the activities you do. You're trying to change the way your students are involved at your school and involved with each other, and the way your staff feels like with respect to being appreciated, right? And that doesn't just come from like two advisors or like a group of five students. That comes from a community. And so you have to have everyone involved, because that's really important. Like, you have to have a wraparound idea of like, or goal, like, we're gonna change this mentality. We're gonna change the way people are appreciated and seen and loved and heard here. And you can't do that without a principal. Like, you can try as you might, but they have more opportunity to do influencing at different levels than you do, and so it's important to do it together.
I think with anything, like, kids like to have choice, and they like to be able to say, I did that, or and take ownership of that. And so a lot of the stuff becomes, if we do it, it just becomes, oh, they did another nice thing for us, and it becomes something that is expected but not necessarily appreciated. And I think when you have a bunch of kids that are doing it for each other, that does, it sets the tone for allowing other kids to say, wait, I want to be a part of that too. Oh, they're going to let me do that. And so it's not just one group of teachers or one group of students. It becomes that you're allowing other students to become leaders as well. So whether they realize it or not, they're actually going to empower the next set of leaders and give all of the kids that are here the confidence to say, hey, let me be part of that too. Let me have a little bit of that.
We both think that it's important to do these things because people are inherently valuable. Just because a kid isn't good at sports, just because a kid isn't good at chemistry, just because they aren't good at math or whatever, doesn't mean that they're not valuable as a person, right? And so that's our opinion, is every kid here matters, and they deserve to know that they matter too. We need to give them opportunities to shine. We need to recognize them when they do. And we need to differentiate that, because every kid is different. And so that's why we think people are important and they deserve to be cared about.
I think that it's important just to life in general. Like, I think there's a lot of negativity that surrounds a lot of things that are going on in our everyday life. And we don't hear a lot of the good stories that happen. And so I think that sharing all of the things that we want to do and plan to do and are going to do, and giving students the opportunity to be a part of that. I think that, you know, you hear stories all the time about kids who hate school, or they don't want to come to school, or they feel like they're left out. And so that's really what we're trying to do, is make it a place that kids can come to school and they know that they're going to be included in something, and that they're welcome here, and that they can come to school freely, and they can come to school with desire to learn, and that this is a safe place. And so I think a lot of kids outside of these walls maybe don't have that safe place. And so if we can provide that safe place and give other students, I think the leadership aspect that Renaissance will provide as well, from things like watching the harbor videos and talking about things that maybe aren't common to talk about every single day, I think that all of those things just kind of coupled together just make a positive impact on both teachers and students and faculty and just your school community in general. And I think the more, like I said at the very beginning, like, this is a close-knit community, so we can, you know, I feel like we have the perfect scenario to build an extremely successful Renaissance culture. My little girl's in second grade, and I know that she has ideas of things that they could do in elementary school. And so I think that if we show and include all of those kids coming up through, like, when they get up here, the sky's the limit for things that they're going to plan to do. And so starting it right now, I think, is just super important moving forward, not just when they're in school, but as they move forward from school and can be involved and feel like they can now make an impact that they may have not felt like before.